Good Sunday, everybody. Jewel here with your tropical update from the Weather Channel of J7409. Before we get into all that, I wanted to tell everyone I did watch everything yesterday and last evening. It looked like Lee might take a direct hit around the Massachusetts area, but that's changed this morning. It changes from time to time. Please watch all of this video to know what's going on as of now. But before we get into all of that, check this out. Looks like a little city. That even looks kind of like the castle of King Solomon to me. See little people all around here guarding it. Well, what that really is, this is what it's looking like at my house. What this really is, this is called a Fatamorgana. Now, I'm probably pronouncing that wrong, but what it amounts to is when the sun is right before the sun comes up, it is reflecting things that is on the other side, and it projects them in the air to look like objects. Maybe sometimes a floating city, maybe boats. You see them on land and on water. But I thought this was really neat, and I wanted to show it to you. From the National Hurricane Center for early today, Sunday, the 10th of September, 2023. Before I get going, I know my friends here, you don't want to hear this, but it is right now a little too soon to know what level of impacts, if any, Lee has along the U.S. East Coast, Atlantic Canada, and for Bermuda. But here we go, right now. Here's what's happening with Lee. His winds is 105 miles per hour. The wind gusts are high. A minimum central pressure around 958 millibars. Located 21.4 north, 60.5 west. Still moving west-northwest. Slowing down 9 miles per hour. And I do expect Lee to continue to slow down. And that's because there's a big high that's expected to be mostly to the southwest over the next day or so, and that's going to slow Lee down. At some point, Lee may even just kind of meander around and stop to 2 or 3 miles per hour before all is said and done. Once again, everything's posted over on the community page. It's updated right now for everybody who is a fisherman and marine category, if you're out in the ocean, and the latest update. Still no watches or warnings for land for Lee. We have Margot. Margot's got 50 mile per hour winds, minimum central pressure 1,000 millibars, located 22.1 north, 39.6 west, moving northwest at 8 miles per hour. Now, looky here, we got two more, and I do think one of these may really try to do something and follow the track of Lee, except it may be a little bit more down around the island area. We're going to check everything out. This is disturbance number one right now, a small area of low pressure. It's a few hundred miles to the southwest of the Cabo Verde Islands. It is producing showers and thunderstorms, and the conditions do appear to be marginally favorable for additional development as this is moving slowly westward over the eastern tropical Atlantic. 2 days, 7 days, 30% chance. We'll keep my eyes on it, and I will keep my eyes on this one. Now, this is another tropical wave. It's going to move off the west coast of Africa during the next day or so. Now, all these conditions also appear conducive for gradual development during the latter part of this week. Now, this one I'm really going to watch, okay? Now, it's going to move westward to west-northwestward, just like Lee. And right now, it's about 15 to 20 miles per hour moving over the eastern and central portions of the tropical Atlantic. In the next 2 days, it's zero. In the next 7 days, it's 30%. It may go up, folks. I'm having that feeling. And on the tracking map from the National Hurricane Center, I'd like to remind everyone that I found this and I made a note. This is from the National Hurricane Center. It still remains that all of the satellite stuff, and we're going to look at the satellite analysts, are suggesting that the GFS may not be accurately reporting some things. It's not accurately representing the environment that is near Lee right now. It's not showing a lot of the shower activity. It's not showing the little bit of dry air I'm going to show you. It's not showing any of that thing. So we will go with the Euro this morning. But back to the map here. Here is Lee right here. Just a hurricane right now with 105 mile per hour winds. That does make it a category 2. But look out. It's going to move so slow, folks. It's going to turn back into a major hurricane, as you can see. Monday, Tuesday, right on up through Wednesday. Now, I think it may get a little closer to the Bahamas. Either way, when it gets right around in this area, it's going to slow up tremendously. I don't think it will turn back into a major hurricane, but it's looking like it is going to stay a hurricane, whether it goes this way, or this way. So everybody, please pay attention. Everybody down in the island areas, Puerto Rico, Dominican Republic, you guys are safe. Jamaica, you are safe. Also over here in the islands here, you are safe from Lee at this time. Quick look at when you might feel some wind from the National Hurricane Center, but I think this might change a little bit. We're going to have to wait and see. But right now, you can see today right down in here, Puerto Rico, it's a long ways from you, and also the Northern Island chain. Very far away from you right now. You may have some 20, maybe 40 mile per hour wind gust, maybe a little lower, maybe a little higher, but nothing that you can't handle. It's not going to be anything concerning hurricane strength winds. Now, as we look at the satellite, up-to-the-minute update right here. This has got it right on it right now. Let's take this off right quick. I said there was a little dry air wrapping around the eastern and northern portion of circulation. Here's the circulation, and this has got some of it right in here. It may be a little hard to see. There is just a little bit of dry air right in this area here of Lee. But it's not stopping Lee. Lee's still moving west-northwest on the southern side of this mid-level high-pressure system. And that high is expected once again to move southwest over the next day or so. And that is going to slow Lee down. Let's bring this down a little bit so we can see what's going on here. Let it load up right quick. We'll move away a little bit. Now, the reason Lee looks blue here is because the satellite's moving, okay? Satellite's moving in and it's beginning to fade out. Over here's Margo. Margo's got some dry air and dry dust in her too, as you can see right in this area here. And as we move up a little bit, here comes another system and then here comes another system. Let's look at these in infrared. Now, Lee, his cloud tops right now, they're still very cold, minus 112 Fahrenheit. So that means Lee still has a lot of power in him, okay? Over here, Margo doesn't look quite as intensive, but she's still in cool, high-top cloud conditions at minus 87 Fahrenheit. This one doesn't look too bad at all, but this one we're going to have to watch because some of the cloud tops, once it gets off, they're going to be minus 80. I have a feeling they will get much, much colder with nothing to bother them when we come on here at all. Nothing to bother them. So let's keep this in mind. Looks like it's going to come off in this dry air, but by the time it actually comes off and gets going, neither one of these really will have a lot of dry dust to contend with. Okay, let's check out the Euro. National Hurricane has already said the GFS isn't working properly and showing everything, so let's go with the Euro. And this is the updated version for today, right now. Now, this is around 3 p.m. this afternoon. Here's Lee. Here's Margot. Pressure in Lee's 28.5. You see, he is still north of the island chain here and Puerto Rico. He should remain that way. We'll move up to Monday, 24 hours later at 3 p.m. Lee is beginning to gain strength, okay? Barometric pressure is falling, 27.95. Let's see what the winds are. Look at there, wind gust 136. That makes it a Cat 4. You know how Lee's jumped around. He's gone from a tropical storm to a Category 3 to a Category 5. And if there were a Category 6, that, and then back down. I mean, Lee's going to keep intensifying, slowing down, speed up, lose wind speed. This is what's going to happen probably until at least close to the end of the week, folks. So let's just move on up in time now. Let's go say 24 more hours, Tuesday around 3 p.m. You can see it's still down in this area, still moving west-northwest. We'll get to Wednesday. I believe now, I took some notes. Wednesday around 3. Let's get up here. Let's get Wednesday around 3. You see where it's at right here. Still got a very low barometric pressure, 28.25 inches. And it's looking like it's still moving west-northwest Wednesday around 3 or 4 o'clock. It's got to make a turn. It's got to make a turn this day for it to miss the U.S. entirely. Now, by 6 o'clock, let's get up to, say, 6 o'clock. Maybe it should move north. It does nudge to the north just a little bit. But look at that eyewall replacement going on. And let's see what the winds are. 115 has slowed down some. It's a Category 3 still at this time with these wind gusts. So Margo's trucking on along. Margo shouldn't bother anyone about anything. As we move down this way, we can see we do have a little low here and a bigger low here. This is the areas that we're going to be watching. But as of Wednesday evening, say around 6 or 7, nothing has developed yet. So we'll go 24 hours into Thursday. Lee is moving north at this time. Still a very low barometric pressure. We'll check the wind. Look how it's dying down. 101. It's going to run into some shear. Some wind shear, folks. And that's what's going to help bring it down. Still, this is a powerful hurricane when the wind gusts are 101 miles per hour. And that does make it a Category 2. Anything happening down here yet? Not yet, but I'm telling you, this system is going to progress as we move along. Let's take Lee now. One more step at the time. By Friday, 24 hours later at 5 p.m., looking like, now, this has changed since last evening. Last evening, it was closer, okay? And it did look like it was going to take a direct hit right up in this area here. That's changed now. But right now, all I can do is show you what it's looking like. A lot of things can happen. A lot of things can change. I would suggest everyone from the Atlantic Canada area all the way down, I'll say to New Jersey, please, please, and I mean North Carolina, Virginia, all of us, we're not out of the woods, but I don't think we're going to have anything but some pretty steady winds, say maybe in the 30s at times, maybe a little rain. But one thing I can tell you, look out Outer Banks. You're going to have beach erosion. This goes for the Inner Banks too. Beach erosion, high surf. The water's probably going to stay high for a while. So just go ahead and prepare for that. We will move up to Saturday. You can see what happens. It escapes It escapes you guys. Now, this doesn't mean you guys aren't going to feel things. I jumped up 24 hours. Let's go back a little bit. And you can see as this moves, looking like the wind's going to stay off for the most part, but looking like up around, we'll come down here right quick so we can get a better view. These winds coming in, 33 miles per hour, so that's not bad at all. Now, for Sunday, say Sunday morning around 8 a.m., looking like now, you can see, look there, Maine, you're going to get some of these winds that project, if you live on the coastline right up in here, all the way up into Canada. I'm not going to go any further out. This is 7 days. Like I said, a lot can change. This is going to give you a pretty good idea of what it's looking like now so people can prepare. And here is the other that I was talking about, looking like it very weak at this time. Got high barometric pressure, but it is trying to build. It's got 46 mile per hour wind gust in it. I think this may be a named storm. It may be a tropical depression at this time. If it is named, its name will be Nigel. Now, on this one, I will go out. Let's say we'll go all the way out far as we can till today, the 19th, and let's see what it's looking like. Boom! It's got all the strength back once again, and it is taking the same path of Lee. So that means we're going to have something else to contend with. So please keep up. Please stay aware. And that, my friends, is what it's looking like on this Sunday, early Sunday forecast here. Thank you so much for watching. Please share this information with your friends, your family, and on your social media to help me keep people aware of what might be coming their way. I really appreciate it when you do that. I hope each of you have a wonderful Sunday, a blessed Sunday. Enjoy your friends and your family. And once again, anywhere right up in these areas here, make sure you're ready if things change. It's too early to tell. I've given you a good outlook on what it's looking like now and what may come. Does not mean that's the way it will play out in the end. It's still too early to tell. So, I love you. Thank you for everything you do for me. I appreciate it so, so very much. Peace, love, and kindness to all. And thank you very much for watching.